Pupils Schools is an international project that asks children to take responsibility for their own environment within the school and within the wider community. And Westercommon School behind me is one of those that are already involved with this project. The children look at areas such as their school grounds, litter, waste, energy, water, health, and they look at all these areas in an effort to improve their school environment. When a school sets up an eco-schools project, they start by getting together a pupil council or eco-committee of pupils to take control of the project. The pupils conduct a review of the school's performance in environmental issues so far, and from there they decide on areas to improve upon. They draw up an action plan and start working towards two or three of the main school areas. Eco-schools is about educating children, but more importantly it's about asking them to take ownership of their environment and of the whole community around them.
The Eco-Schools project is citywide, and for the teachers and pupils of St Joan of Arc Secondary School in Lambhill, care for the environment and recycling are part of their everyday activities.
Yes. Is that solar panel?
Yes.
Half of the power coming from that panel goes to a battery,
yes.
The rest goes to the pump.
The pump up the water.
We recycle rubbish, like papers and all that, so we can make it like into an eco-school. We're going to pick them all first and then we get them down the stairs.
All right. As you can see, I've been very busy. These bins came from the council and they get taken back to Palmady every 2 weeks. They come in, the council comes and empties the paper bin. But we did this as part of the Super Bowl and we've continued with it because it's been such a successful venture.
And what's the Super Bowl?
The Super Bowl is an environmental competition for all secondary schools in Glasgow, and St Joan of Arc were the winners last year, 2003.
In the technical department we decided, seeing as the garden outside was being done up, that we'd maybe make a bench for the garden. So I ordered some wood from the wood school in the Borders, which uses sustainable forests in the Borders. A lot of wood they take is actually wood that would normally be burnt or just left to rot. So we're taking elm wood, which is good for outside furniture, and we're making a bench.
The school uses biodegradable plastic throughout its canteen, but polystyrene products are non-recyclable.
I was pure outraged, absolutely devastated, that they weren't even able to melt it down and reforge it as something else. No. Couldn't even make it in a drinking straw.
So what do you think should be done with it?
I think this stuff should be scrapped and brought, a new can should be brought in, which would help the environment, not make it worse. It is time to stop and re-break.
At Kelvinhaugh Primary School, something quite revolutionary is happening in the garden.
Super Bowl.
Have you all got Super Bowl t-shirts?
Yeah.
Let's see.
The Trust have landscaped this garden, providing growing bays and compost bins for what is fast becoming a showcase environmental educational project. The coach house staff provide guidance for the children as they learn about the different aspects of maintaining their garden.
What do you do?
Feed worms.
Worms!
Whoa!
I'm trying to get it in my finger.
Squeeze them.
This one's tail is falling off.
How do you know his head from his tail?
Because that he's going that way.
But maybe he's reversing.
We dig and we pick up litter. And
can somebody else hold this for me, please?
We were collecting the litter for wildlife. And, yeah, to keep it in good shape, you know.
We get fruit and all the, when we're finished, we put it in a fruit bin and we get all the things for the fruit bin and we put it, we get it over on a big board over there and
we get a
spade and we chop it up and then we put it in for the worms to eat.
No bother!
It's because I was home gardening. Broken wood that people have left around from cutting the trees, and we're going to use it as a with our compost heap. And if you mix it in with little green stuff like cabbages, like we feed to the worms, it'll and then little lives. Little things will come and eat it and turn it into very nice soil.
How do we make compost? Well, this gets...
We're making bean things for the beans